Hi guys, we've got a bit of a special video today, and this video will be in memory of Top Gear, as you may have heard all the stuff about Top Gear recently. So we thought that in memory of it, sort of how it is at the minute, we would have our own Top Gear race. I'm not going to keep you now, just enjoy the video. Thanks for watching.
Tonight, I fly a plane. William can't see out of a car. And we drop a car.
Hello and welcome. On tonight's show, we will be bringing you quite a few stuff. But to start off with you tonight, we have a two-part race between me and dark-woozy. So without any further ado, let the games begin. Okay, so the race is going to be simple. We start all the way up here in Blaine County. I will be taking a plane, and we'll be taking his car, and we'll be driving down, all the way down, and the first one to make it down to the airport will be the clear winner. Right, okay, then on your marks, get set, go.
Wait, oh shit, oh, hello. I'm not panicking. I've got no rush.
Come on. Here we go. Let's go. Five miles to go. Here we go. And we're up in the sky. I am en route. I don't know. Just casually like Oh god, you're way ahead! I can see you! You can get some altitudes, I can easily soar over here. That's the first hangar on by there. We can just see Will just disappearing on the map behind us. Alright, I'm just gonna take a little bit of a shortcut. Went wrong, but here we go. Carry on. Let's do this. Come on. How close? I think we can get closer than that. I think I can get closer. Loop de loop. This is how confident I am.
Are you actually doing a loop de loop?
I am. I'm doing a loop de loop. This is how confident.
Why do there have to be so many cars on the road? I mean, why do people go out?
Right, so from the new heist update, there have been a few new vehicles, and we have left it down to dark-woozy to test one of the newest vehicles.
Hi and welcome. We are testing the carrying Karuma, and we're going to test it on speed and handling off the mark. It is really quick car to have. It's nice. It does handle really well. And this costs 95,000, and there is an armored version which costs 525,000. So that's 430,000 more than this, but it's not much more. We're gonna have a drag race. So this is the armored version. Personally, I think that looks horrible, just because it's all boarded up and it's just not nice. Just gonna get in and see the view inside. As you can see, you can't see out the windows much. It's not a nice view to see from first person. So we can go back to our... We can start our drag race to see which car is the quickest. First person drag race. If we start from, we'll start from further back so we get a longer race. This next line. First person, race. So, 3, 2, 1, go. So suddenly it does start catching up. It's got, the armored one has got an engine level 4 upgrade. I've only got level 3. So as you can see, it is quite quick already. And I've got another engine upgrade to go yet. So this will be quite a really quick car. Back to the studio.
Right now, some time ago, We decided to test a few vehicles and see how well we could push them. We decided to test one in particular and push it to its absolute limit. This is Test It to Destruction.
We are doing a Test It to Destruction. We've picked this car out at random and we are going to put it for its paces today. So first car which is going to go through our Test It to Destruction is the Carrying Rusty Rebel. This Test It to Destruction, we will be testing normal cars which you can just find off the street in order to decipher which car, in our opinion, is the best car that you can pick off the streets for a getaway, or which car which that will last. Yeah, that's pretty much, and this is what we're testing today. Right, guys, this is test number two. The test two, how it bears up against cops. So we've got some cops chasing us here. This is gonna be, and I, to make it more realistic, I am actually going to do what any normal one of us would do, and that is fire back. made a good jump, did he?
Over the whole corner.
No, I didn't.
Off the bridge.
Ah, oh, missed a cop. We've lost a tyre, okay. So, I'm not taking as much damage, to be honest. I'll admit, I'm getting hit, like, a decent amount, but it's not, like, major damage here. We also see how much the car this can pick up speed and how the handling bears up against this jump here as well. So, you have to tell me how the handling is for this jump. I take that that looked quite easy to control there.
It was really easy.
It was.
Yeah.
Okay, that's yeah. So, in all fairness, test 2 I think is a success. Right, guys, test number 3 is life lasting. We got my friend here shooting the engine and. Once the engine is on fire, I will drive off and see how long the car will last. Right, it's on fire.
Go.
You shot my tyres out, that's not much help, but right, okay. So we're going a decent distance at the minute. Well, we haven't got too far away. But we've got to be prepared because our tyres are going to go. Okay. So we didn't get too far down the road. But I think that proves that. But I will say though that did get quite a decent distance though actually. Like it got a decent. I did. Like I got quite away before it blew up. I think if I would have probably got a bit further if my tyres hadn't have blown. If you hadn't blown my tyres out.
Do it again, then.
But no, I think that's okay. That's okay. This is right now we are doing test number 4 and this is terrain. We are testing all the types of terrain where we think it can handle. And how it handles over fair amount of terrain. Okay, we did a jump, but it didn't work. But it works decently. I think despite our driver's crappy driving, this thing is handling up all right. I mean, this is
driving is not crappy.
It's actually it's all right. It just seems to be. Except for that bit of wedge there, but I don't think any car would have got up that anyway. So, I mean, okay. So, terrain, not a good woohoo. So that's terrain's not sort of woohoo in here at the minute. I reckon if we give it a really good push, it could get it, but. I think we're going to have to call this one a fail. This is not going to get up there, and it can cover nearly all terrains, but it's not exactly all terrain. Okay, guys, this is test number 5. Durability. We have gone up as high as we can get here, pretty much, and we're going to drop the Karen. It's in near perfect. We're gonna drop the Karen. It's in near perfect condition, just like a few windows broken, and this will test its durability. So we're any further ado. We'll be right back.
Okay. It did not survive the test. I blew up immediately on impact. And that's that, I guess. The Karen Rebel is okay for your speedy getaways and what have you, but it's not very durable. I think we have learnt that today. Right, and now we have the last part of our two-part race. Here we go. Who will win?
I could have been there by now. Oh, God. Oh, here we go. And I am nearly here. Are you joking?
You're actually nearly there. You nearly landed.
I'm nearly there. Wheels out. Preparing for the lander. About to land. Come on. Landed.
You're at the hangar.
Here we go. Just gonna go into the hangar. Nearly at the hangar. Come on. And I'm just gonna. Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Come on! Come on! No! 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 Ah! Get in there! Come on! Come on! Oh, that was a close call. That was a close call, man.
I think we'd have to call that a draw.
Oh. Well, I think it's fair to say that I won that one. Easily.
Well, that's all of everything we have for tonight. Thanks for watching. And on that bombshell, good night. Hi guys, thanks for watching our special Top Gear race video. We hope you enjoyed watching it as we did creating it. Don't forget to check out some of our other stuff, like and subscribe, and we will see you guys next time.